Hi, my name is Vishwesh Vankhede.
And myself, Raghav Sharma.
We are from Symbiosis College of Arts and Commerce. So we have this concept called as Symbipreneurs, in which we interview the alumni who are into entrepreneurship. And for that reason, today we have decided to call Mr. Rohit Thakur, founder of Zazz Media. So hi, my first question to you is, are you a first generation entrepreneur? And how did you come up with this idea of yours?
Firstly, thank you very much for inviting me. To answer your question, yes, I am a first generation entrepreneur. How did I come up with the idea is actually very interesting. After my graduation back in May 2015, I actually took a 6 months break where I wasn't sure what I'm going to do in the future. I knew at a much earlier point in my life that I am going to go into entrepreneurship, but the exact timeline wasn't sure. So I took this break to figure out my life, to figure out what I'm going to do, and I didn't want to rush into anything. So I took that break, and suddenly I got that calling within me that now it's time to get up and do something. When that happened, then I started playing on my strengths. I started noting down what my strengths are, what my weaknesses are. Once I came to know that, then I started figuring out what I can do with the strengths. And that is where the idea of an advertising agency clicked me. And that is how Zazz Media came into existence.
Okay, so what were your hurdles in those?
So there are a lot of micro failures actually. There are macro failures also, but by micro failures what I mean is, because I had just started a company right after my graduation, I didn't know how to run a company. I didn't know exactly how to approach clients, what my pricing should be, what my process should be. So I experimented a lot. I failed a lot, I did a lot of mistakes, but because of those mistakes, I knew what I had to do then. And each time I make a mistake, I'm very happy that I got the opportunity to make those mistakes, and that's how I'm here.
So my next question to you is, how important innovation is for an enterprise, and what innovation have you done?
So yes, innovation is very, very important. So in December 2018, we completed 3 years of Zazz Media. In this entire journey, what I've learned is you need to keep pivoting whenever you think that you're making mistakes, whenever you realize those mistakes, and whenever you think there's some or the other problem in your organization, you need to think how you can innovate and do a better job. So if it comes to my management skills, to my operations, or speaking from the industry, how can I innovate in digital advertising? Because the market is oversaturated right now. So how can I innovate and do a better job for the clients basically? So I need to keep innovating within the organization and for the clients also, so that I can grow. To give you a very basic example of innovation, what used to happen in my earlier days was, because I understood what digital marketing is and how it should be done, but I didn't know how to do it on a micro level, on a day-to-day level. So when we got the clients' contracts, I used to always think it from one day's point of view. So what needs to be done today for the client, instead of thinking from the week or the month's perspective. So every day when we used to come in the office, the first thing that we used to think is what needs to be done for the client. What needs to be posted on the client's profile basically. So that was a mistake, that digital advertising doesn't happen in that manner. The clients were very open and fortunate. We were very fortunate basically that we had such good clients who stuck with us basically in this phase, because they didn't know this process. But through time I understood, and now I'm in such a phase that I have the entire month's plan ready beforehand. So right now April has just started, and now I have the entire April's plan ready for everyone. So that's the innovation that I have done for myself in my organization.
Oh, that's good. How did Symbi, what made you become an entrepreneur? Like being in college, like what I've heard of, like they have events like campus entrepreneur and many other things like that. So did that make you?
Firstly, let me tell you this, becoming an entrepreneur was something that I decided in a very early stage of my life, sometime when I was in school.
Okay.
that could be because I come from a family business background. But I had this thing in mind that I want to make my own mark. I won't be joining my family business. But at the same time, this is, I think, back in my 5th grade or 6th grade, when I knew that I was going to do something of my own. And back in those days, this is 2005-2006, back in those days, these words like entrepreneur weren't mainstream.
That's right.
So I always had this that I am going to become a businessman. I am going to open my own business. It's now since, I think, last 5 years that everyone has started using the words entrepreneur. But to come to the Symbiosis point of view, I think I'm a person who's very anti-educational system. So there are pros and cons, right? But I think for me, how Symbiosis helped me is the entrepreneurship development cell. That is something that groomed me, that clarified to me what entrepreneurship is. The case studies that we used to do, the field visits, the projects that we used to get was something that was different from the classic education system that we have come from. So even in the degree that I had done, it was the same thing, exams, the competition, competing with your fellow colleagues and not learning anything basically. Entrepreneurship development cell was something that gave me that platform.
So what all opportunities did you see in yourself in the business world?
So basically, I think this asks the why of me being an entrepreneur, right? So I think this was something through which I knew how to provide value back into the world. So I always had this intention, aside from the fact that I wanted to become an entrepreneur, I always had this intention that one, I wanted to inspire a lot of people. And second, I wanted to provide a lot of value back. So sometimes it's always the case that we think of ourselves and it's kind of a selfish world where we think, what can I do for myself and how can I grow? But at the same time, I always had this thought in my mind that whatever I do and whatever I'll do aside from that fact in my life, personal life also, I wanted to give back because I have already got so much. I live a privileged life. That doesn't mean that I've grown to where I want to be, but if I have a roof over my head and if I'm getting daily food, then I live a privileged life. That's the fact. So with that in mind, I knew that I wanted to provide value either through my organization or through my personal life. So that, I think, answers your question.
My question to you is, why Zazz Media?
So, said that I wanted to provide value. One why of Zazz Media is that I could provide value back to the clients. And because I was also skilled in digital marketing, so that I think gave me the platform to provide the value. Second, it sounds very easy that I wanted to provide value where everyone is, but at the same time, there are a lot of people who are scamming the clients in the digital marketing world. So what that means is, either through your charges or through the packages that the agencies used to provide, they used to scam the clients. Or third, there were some who didn't focus on the mid-tier clients or the startups who, whereas we are still a startup phase, right? So we come within that same mentality that what about them? So we always had that in mind. So that is how I knew I wanted to provide value. And second, I think this is the first time that I'm disclosing this in this interview, that Zazz Media was always supposed to be that machine which helps me in my future startups as well. So that was another intention of mine. You can call it a bit selfish hearing this, but there's a lot of value creation that's going to happen in the future. But yes, it is supposed to be a machine. One of the base platforms in my future plans.
So my question to you is, have you had other businesses in Zazz Media before?
So very interesting question. I don't speak much about this, but during my second year, that is where you all are at right now, I had started a small production firm by the name of Shranwit Productions. So I was very enthusiastic about photography and cinematography. and I wanted to pursue it professionally. And at that time, it was the hot trend and everyone was going by their own name and starting a Facebook page, etc. So we thought that why not take a more professional approach. So we had got the entire branding done, all done by ourselves, the visiting cards, the brochures, all that kinds of thing, so that it looks like a proper company. And then we ran it for a year. The intention behind it was to only experience the professional side of the industry. For me, I never wanted to get fully in the industry. It was just to experiment and to see how people react to it. And I was very amateur at the time, so and we still got projects, so nice. That's an advantage.
So would you share some thrilling experience? What made you like?
Definition of thrill and my definition of thrill is completely different. Okay. Let me tell you why. So for me, my thrill is my failures and getting to learn from those failures. So 6 months into my startup, I thought of a new idea and I thought, why not come up with a second venture? Because I can do it, it's all my own. I had this was the mindset back then, that it's all my own, so why not come up with a second venture? So I rushed into it without proper planning and proper execution. And since I didn't prioritize it, it worked for a month or something and then it stopped. Jumped to 1.5 years later, that is December 2017, I think, is when I sat like a proper month with that idea, made the whole business plan as to how I should execute it. And then I thought, this is it for me. Now I'm going to go hardcore into this. Next month, Zazz Media kickstarts. I run into that now, the activities, and I have to keep this on the sideline. And that was a very big thrilling adventure for me, because mindset-wise, there were a lot of switches going on.
So are you planning to continue this business again?
So like I said earlier, that it's all about pivoting and all about innovations. So I've innovated that idea now, more of 2019 trend, and hopefully I think this is the year. For the third venture.
Oh, wow.
So what has been your inspiration, or who has been your inspiration?
So whatever we are, not individually myself, but whatever we are is an amalgamation of the people we meet and the experiences that we have. So that applies to me also. But moreover than that, for me, my inspiration has been Gary Vaynerchuk. Not many people, especially in India, know him, but he's a big entrepreneur from the same advertising field itself, and the reason behind my mindset change, the reason behind my entrepreneurial thinking, the reason behind my pivoting in the advertising industry has all been thanks to him. So I'm very grateful that I could find his content on the internet, and he himself is so passionate about sharing that content to the world that I am one of millions of people who are getting that, receiving that content basically, and taking advantage out of it, because it's all free out there. But yes, my main role model, my inspiration is him.
Do you think there's some formula or pattern in becoming a successful entrepreneur?
There is one. Not many people will tell you this. I don't think it's in your theory books. There is one formula through which any entrepreneur can succeed. Do you want to know it?
Yeah,
why not?
Obviously.
It's one word, and I don't know why people don't say it often. It's hard work. So it seems very easy, you know?
Yeah,
and I purposely wanted to put my answer this way, because then everyone says that, you know, hard work is the answer. Mm-hmm. But you know, when you twist it this way, then you get that eagerness.
Yeah.
What is the answer? What is the answer? But the answer is very easy actually. So no matter how many ideas you plan, it's all on execution. And that execution is hard work basically. So it's how you execute is how you're going to grow. And you need to have your goals in mind. What is going to make you happy? You don't need to see another entrepreneur or another organization and see, I want to reach there. You need to find within yourself that, where do I need to reach? What should be my goals and what's going to make me happy? Maybe earning, say, 5 lakhs a month and doing whatever you want at, whatever you are passionate about is going to make you very happy. At the same time, you can make 5 crores in a year, but be ultimately unsatisfied. Then what do you choose? Because our societal status says that you need to choose money, and that's how people are going to recognize you. But then what about yourself? There's your answer.
So what has been your success mantra?
Discipline. If you had asked me the same question back in July or August 2018, that is, my answer would have been different. Back then, for the first 2.5 years, I was of this mindset that since I was running my own business and it's all on my own terms, I can do whatever I want and whenever I want. So I had this habit of doing sitting up till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock at night and finishing off the work. And at that time, my thinking used to be I'm getting an advantage over my morning's tasks, where I was wrong. And then I used to wake up at 11 or 12 in the morning. Back then, I had this thinking that whatever I'm doing, basically I'm finishing all my tasks, and as long as those projects are getting complete and I'm happy in whatever I'm doing, then who's got a problem in what? The problem was there was no discipline and there was no growth. And because there was no growth, I was at the same stage for a long amount of time. So when I understood that, that is where the whole mindset change happened for me. So when that happened, when I brought discipline into my life, I started it small and then I took it into my entire day's work. So now my lifestyle is such that I wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm in bed by 10 or 11. I have this very fixed morning schedule of my exercise, of my breakfast, when my work is supposed to start. I have to take 15 minutes or a half an hour break every 3 hours, no matter how much work do you have on your shoulders. I have to take that break because that's how I get back more productively the second time. If I put in those 8 or 9 hours continuously, so this applies to different people, this is my process. So if I put in those 8 or 9 hours, it's going to be a very unproductive day for me. And in entrepreneurship, it's not just 8 or 9 hours, it's basically 12 hours, 13 hours, 14 hours, depending on the day. But with that discipline, I've had a massive growth in me since the last 7 or 8 months. So yeah, I think discipline is the mantra.
Would you like to leave any message for the budding entrepreneurs?
Two messages, actually. One is, don't get into entrepreneurship because it's the hot trend and because everyone is doing it. You need to find within yourself if entrepreneurship is for you or not. That brings me to my second point. The why of entrepreneurship is very important. People get an idea and they get into entrepreneurship because the thinking is, if I have an idea, then I can do it. But the why is very important. Why should I get into entrepreneurship? Is it for the freedom? Is it for the money? Is it for the recognition? You need to answer that for yourself. And then you need to reverse engineer that goal into if getting into entrepreneurship is the right step for me. Because taking an idea into execution phase, there's more to it than that. You have to handle an entire company, you have to handle people, you have to handle clients, you have to handle sales. So it's not very easy that I have this idea, and there's never an overnight idea that you can take into execution the next day. So what's the potential of that idea? Is it sustainable? Is it going to bring me money? What value am I providing to the people? If it answers all those questions, then yes, you should get into entrepreneurship. Not just because it's the hot trend. So I think, yeah, that's my message for the upcoming entrepreneurs.
Brings us to the end of our talk with me, Rohit. Thank you for coming here today.
Thank you for inviting me.
It's a pleasure.
Had a great time. Thank you very much. Yeah.